You know, in old paintings of the crucifix and the crucifixion, the nails appear to be driven into the middle of Christ's hands. Now, in the Shroud of Turin, it appears from the blood stains they were in his wrists. Could you please clear up this confusion? Thanks, Marta. And it's also sometimes that comes up in the question of people with stigmata and where the location is as well, and why there seems to be a discrepancy if there is one. What are your thoughts?
Yeah, you're absolutely right, Marta. In the actual burial shroud of Turin, we see that the imprints going of the nails for the hands go, you know, angularly up into the wrists and then up through the back part of the wrist, almost into the base of the hand, and then into the wood. And as it turns out, that's precisely where the Romans would have had to have done it. Because if they'd actually put it into the flesh of the hand right here, this is a very fleshy part of the hand. And if they had put it there and tried to nail Jesus to the cross, within 1 second, his arms would have just pulled right through those, his hands would have pulled right through those nails, and his arms would have been dangling there, and his body would have gone over, right? And of course, the Romans, being very experienced people, good experimentalists, as it were, they knew exactly where to put those nails so that the body, the hands would not rip away or rip through them, but would actually hold him fast so that he would have to suffocate. So unfortunately, those depictions in the paintings, they were off. I mean, you know, the artists weren't really thinking about physiology and anatomy, and they really weren't thinking about real crucifixion. They just, you know, thought they, you know, when the biblical writer said through the hands, they thought it was through the hands. But what they meant was it was through the base of the hand, and it comes up through the back of the hand very slightly at the base there. And that's the way the biblical writers described it. And the same thing with the feet. It's really going into the into the ankle there, you know, as well. But essentially, that was just a mistake of depiction in the paintings. With respect to the stigmata as well, you know, I think God chooses to put the stigmata into the fleshy part of the hand because it would be, it's painful but manageable.
I see.
Right?
Okay.
If it were actually in the wrist, you couldn't use your hand at all. Okay. You'd be hitting that nerve. You would be able to do nothing with your hands at all. So our Lord, you know, obviously gave those wounds in a very practical place for the saints to receive the blessing of the crucifixion, yet at the same time not be rendered immobile.